warrior, because that's what he is. If you look at his entire career, I talked to him not too long ago, and he was sounding a lot stronger and more like himself. So I think he'll be back to pester us before too long, and I certainly hope so. And we'll send him greetings, because he would be pleased to see all of you today too. It was mentioned that I've been involved with this museum for a long time and this center, and I was very pleased to do that in the legislature, working to get this building. We got some money. Many of you in this room helped me do that and testified in behalf of it to bring school children here. But one of the very interesting things was the license plate that we got. Just to, if you'll indulge me for a minute, we got the special license plate to raise money for the museum and had a competition for the design of it. Now, the original design was a mushroom cloud. Now, George Knapp, who's the newscaster, thought that was great. He said that license plate could kick sand in the face of any other license plate on the road, and it got quite a lot of attention. So much attention that the BBC called me. I was in Europe on holiday, and my husband was reading the International Herald Tribune. He said, "Oh my God, here's an article about your license plate in Las Vegas." Well, I guess cooler heads prevailed, and they changed the design on the license plate, but I'm glad to see there are a lot of them out there supporting the museum. But I still think if we kept that mushroom cloud, we might have sold more of them. That was a good symbol. But the reason that I do that is a labor of love, and it's about what you all do and why we're here today, to this day of remembrance. Because the sacrifices that have been made in the atomic testing programs and the research and the development on that battlefield are just as great and just as important as the sacrifices that were made by anybody in the conventional battle zones. And we don't want to ever forget that. But too often, it is overlooked. And so that's why this day of remembrance is so important. You know, the statistics are pretty impressive. Over 500,000 Americans have worked since 1942 to create and maintain America's nuclear arsenal, which has kept us safe and served as a deterrent and helped to defeat communism. And many of these workers have suffered from health problems, radiation or toxic exposure, before some of the dangers were even known. And so they need our support just as any other veterans do. We say you need leave nobody on the field in battle. We want to leave no veterans behind when they come home. And we want to be sure that our atomic veterans and those who work in all of the nuclear industry to keep us safe also have the services that they need. So I salute all of you. I know many of you. I've worked with many of you over the years. It is something that I'm very proud of, and I'm so glad this museum is right in the heart of District 1. We are getting more tourists, more school children, more people coming to do research, and I know there are big plans for continuing to tell this story. We're all very proud of this. We're very grateful to everything that you've done. And please always come to me. Consider me a friend and an advocate. If there's anything you need, I'm there to try to return the great service that you have given to all of us. Thank you for letting me be here today. And Alan, I too have paper. But government is up and running again, and I'm here in person, so there you go.
Thank you so much, Dina. And again, this place wouldn't be where it is today without Dina's help and many of you in this room, too. So thank you again from us. It also gives me now pleasure to introduce a very special person here today, representing the Cold War Patriots. That organization is you, many of you in this room. It also represents all the things that we stand for. And here to speak on behalf of the Cold War Patriots today is Kevin Fitzgerald.
Thank you, everyone. 1945, the beginning of the atomic age. The Manhattan Project led to the development of the atomic bomb by the United States, which ended World War II and paved the way in preserving the national security and the freedoms we all enjoy today. Over 700,000 Americans, including many of you who worked at the Nevada test site, worked to maintain our nation's nuclear deterrent. We are here today to honor you and the patriotic men and women who supported our nuclear efforts during World War II and the Cold War. The U.S. Senate, in a rare sign of nonpartisanship, has unanimously approved October 30th, 2013, as a National Day of Remembrance to recognize the thousands of dedicated workers who often worked in secrecy and sometimes in harm's way for the safety of the United States. We are proud to say this is the fifth year that the Senate has unanimously passed the resolution to commemorate this special day. I know many of you out there are uncomfortable with being honored today. You don't feel like you should be called patriots, that you were just doing a job that needed to be done. But let me assure all of you who are patriots, Cold War patriots, and that's why we're here to celebrate with you today. Without all of your contributions, the world as we know it would be a very, very different place. Thank you for what you did and the sacrifices that you made. And I also want to take this opportunity to thank the National Atomic Testing Museum and the Cold War Patriots Organization for their continued efforts to raise awareness and carry on the tremendous legacy of the nuclear and uranium workers who were part of the most transformative event in our nation's history. So thank you all again, and God bless America.
Kevin, thank you very much. You know, one of the things, the fun things about being a museum director is occasionally something happens in your day, and it's not very many days this doesn't happen, where somebody walks in the door with a really amazing story. And this happened about 2 years ago. This guy walked in and he said, because we had an exhibit here with a couple of pictures of Camp Desert Rock out here at the test site years ago. And this guy walked in and he says, "That's me in that picture." And I said, "Really?" And so he was interested in getting a copy of it. So the more that one of my admissions people talked with him, the more that we realized that he had an amazing story that was directly connected with the test site. His name is Al Sue, and Al lives in Honolulu, Hawaii, and is with us today because I asked him, because one of the things that happens in the business of a museum and also in what we're talking about with patriotism and people is sometimes a people story gets a little lost. So Al's one of those people who's got a people story I think you'd be kind of interested in, and I wanted him to be here today in person to tell us, because I think you may be as fascinated with it as I was, and I hope that just like my day that was made when I first met Al years ago, yours may be enriched a little bit by this story as well. So it's a pleasure to introduce Al Sue, 82nd Airborne Division.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's just an honor to be here. You know, I'm just a grunt. And when I was put in the position where I experienced what I had experienced, and I'm grateful for this. And I'm grateful for this country. By the way, you know, when Alan called me, he said that we were wanting to talk about some of my experience. And I told him that, well, this was a great honor, and I was glad you didn't ask me to say. No, really, because the last time I was asked to sing, it was at a funeral. Yeah, really, because this person knew that I knew the song, "Nearer My God to Lead My Heart," and the original singer was not there. For some reason, he wasn't there, so he asked, "Would you sing the song? Because I know you know the song well." I said, "Well, I'm going to try," and so I sung the song. It was so bad. I never want to, no, really, I never want to do that again because the organ is just quit playing. And I kept singing. And after I sang, and it was bad, it was like, I mean, really bad. But anyway, they're all people.